Welcome to this walkthrough guide on how to use custom building blocks in Google Docs. Are you tired of typing out the same phrases, contact details, or project descriptions over and over again? Maybe you're spending too much valuable time recreating tables or formatting specific sections just the way you need them. Well, what if I told you there's a powerful built-in Google Docs feature that's designed to eliminate these exact frustrations? It's called Custom Building Blocks, and it's your key to working smarter, not harder. Let's get started. All right, let's dive into the heart of it, creating your very first custom building block. This is the foundational step, and once you master this, you'll see just how much potential this feature holds. Think of a custom building block as a personal library of content snippets that you can summon with just a couple of clicks. Now on my screen, you can see I have a paragraph of text. Let's imagine this is our standard company contact information: address, phone number, website, the lot. I frequently need to add this to the end of letters, proposals, or even some emails that I draft in Docs. Typing this out every single time, or even finding an old document to copy it from, is not just tedious, it's also where mistakes can creep in. This makes it a perfect candidate for a custom building block. So the very first thing I need to do is to tell Google Docs what content I want to save. I'm going to carefully select all the text that makes up this contact block. It's important to grab everything that you want to reuse, including any specific formatting like bold text or bullet points, because the building block will preserve all of that formatting for you. Okay, with my contact information highlighted, I'll now move my mouse cursor anywhere over this selected area and right-click. Doing this opens up a context menu. From this menu, we're looking for the option that says, quite intuitively, Save as Custom Building Block. We're going to click on that. And there we have it, the Save as Custom Building Block dialog box. This is where we give our new block its identity. You'll see two fields, name and description. For the name, it's really crucial to be descriptive. This is how you'll find your block later on. Since this is our main company contact information, I'll call it Company Contact Block. The key is to use a name that will immediately tell you what the block contains when you see it in a list. Avoid really generic names like My Text or Paragraph 1, because trust me, you'll quickly forget what they refer to as your library of blocks grows. Next up is the description field. This is optional, but I find it incredibly useful, especially if the name alone isn't quite enough detail or if a block has a very specific purpose. For our company contact block, I could add something like full company address, main phone, and general inquiries email. This little note is a great reminder. Once I'm happy with the name and my optional description, all that's left to do is click on the blue Create button. And that's it. We've successfully created and saved our first custom building block. That entire chunk of contact information, with its formatting, is now stored safely in our personal library, ready to be used whenever we need it in any Google Doc we own. Think of the possibilities here. That complex table structure that you always use for your monthly financial reports, save it as a block. That standard disclaimer that you need to add to certain documents, save it as another block. You're essentially building your own toolkit of frequently used content. Brilliant, we've now created our company contact block and it's now part of our personal toolkit. So the next logical step is learning how to actually use it, aka how to insert these saved blocks into your documents. This is where you'll really start to see the time-saving benefits begin to kick in. Okay, I'm now in a new document, or it could be an existing one I'm working on. Let's say I've just finished writing up this business letter and I need to add our company contact details at the very end. Instead of typing it all out again or hunting for that other document to copy and paste from, I can just use our new block. The quickest, and in my opinion, the slickest way to insert a custom building block is by using the at symbol. Watch this. I'll simply type the at symbol directly into my document, right here where I want the contact block to appear. As soon as I type the at symbol, Google Docs brings up this rather clever smart canvas menu. It's context-aware and suggests various things that you might want to insert, like people, dates, or, importantly for us, building blocks. Now I'll start typing the name I gave my block, Company Contact Block. See how, as I type, the list below filters down? And there it is, under the building blocks heading, Company Contact Block. Google Docs has found it for me. To insert it, I just need to click on its name in this list, or I can even use the arrow keys to select it and then press enter. And voila, just like that, the entire contact block, perfectly formatted, has been inserted directly into my document. How easy was that? Now imagine you've just drafted a lengthy proposal and you need to pop in a standard terms and conditions section that you've saved as a block. Just simply use the at symbol, type a keyword, click, and it's done. No fuss. Now there's also another way to insert your blocks, which is through the main menu. If you prefer a more traditional menu approach, you can go up to the insert menu at the top of your screen. Then navigate down to building blocks. You'll see a little side menu appear, and one of the options will be custom building block. If you move your mouse over to the custom building block option and select it, it will then display a list of all your custom building blocks that you've saved. And there's our company contact block again. I can simply click on its name in this list, and it gets inserted into the document at my cursor's current location. Both the at symbol method and this insert menu method achieve exactly the same outcome, so you can use whichever workflow you find more intuitive and faster for you. Okay, so we know how to create blocks and how to insert them. But what happens when information changes? Perhaps your company moves office, a phone number is updated, or you just want to refine the wording in a standard clause that you've saved. This is where editing your custom building blocks comes in. And the process is very direct, treating your blocks like the little mini dedicated documents that they are. To edit one of your custom building blocks, it's quite straightforward. When you type the at symbol and start typing the name of your block, like our company contact block, you'll see it appear in the Smart Canvas list. As you hover your mouse cursor over the block's name in that list, you'll notice that there's a little small pencil icon that's to the right of it. This pencil icon is your direct link to editing that specific block. Clicking this pencil icon will open the custom building block in a new browser tab. You'll see that the block itself is essentially its own mini Google Doc, containing just the content that makes up that particular block. Now within this new tab, you can make any changes you need. Let's use our company contact block here as the example. Our original phone number was 9999888, but let's say it's now changed to 7777666. I'll simply edit the text here in this dedicated document for the block to reflect the new phone number. And the great thing about Google Docs, as you probably know, is its auto-save feature. As you make your changes to the block's content in this tab, Google Docs automatically saves them in the background. You'll typically see a status message like saving and then saved to drive appear at the top of the document. There's no separate save button that you need to press for the content itself. Once you've made all your edits and you see that the changes have been saved, you can simply close this browser tab for that building block. Now back in your original document, the letter or proposal that you were working on, the next time you go to insert that company contact block, it will automatically use the updated version containing the new phone number. Any future insertions of this block in any of your documents will reflect these changes that you just made. It's a very efficient way to ensure your boilerplate content stays current everywhere. This method is fantastic for things like updating terms in a service agreement block that you've saved, or if your company logo changes and you have to use it in a signature block, you can edit it in one central place and it's updated for all future uses. Now, as your collection of custom building blocks grows, you'll inevitably find that some become outdated or are no longer needed. Perhaps it was for a one-off project or an old promotion. Keeping your library tidy is good practice, and deleting blocks is also managed through Google Drive, which makes sense because that's where they live. To delete a custom building block, you'll start by going to the Insert menu at the top of your Google Docs screen. Then, navigate down to Building Blocks. From the side menu that appears, you'll want to click on the option that says Custom Building Block. When you click this, the pop-up menu will appear on your screen, near where your cursor is positioned in the document. This menu will show you a few of your existing blocks and an option to create a new custom building block. What we're interested in for deleting is at the very bottom of this pop-up. You should see an option that says Manage Custom Blocks, accompanied by the Google Drive icon. Clicking on Manage Custom Blocks will open up a new browser tab. This tab takes you directly to a specific search page within your Google Drive. This is the central hub where you can see all your custom building blocks, each one as an individual Google Docs file. To delete a block, let's use our example of an old Christmas promo 2024 block that's no longer relevant. Simply find it in the list of files. Then, just like you would with any other file in Google Drive, you'll use the options to remove it. Typically, you can click the three vertical dots, the ellipsis menu, that appears when you hover over the file name. From this menu, you'll choose the option to move the file to the bin. You may be asked to confirm the deletion. Once you do that, the building block, which is that physical file, is moved to your Google Drive's bin. It will no longer appear in your app menu suggestions or in the building blocks menu in Google Docs. It's treated just like any other deleted drive file, which means you also might be able to restore it from the drive bin for a certain period if you delete it by mistake. This integration with Google Drive makes managing your blocks quite intuitive once you realize that they are essentially just special document files. So cleaning out old project templates or seasonal greeting blocks becomes a standard file management task. Now, we've touched on naming a few times throughout this video, but it's so crucial for making custom building blocks truly efficient that I want to dedicate a specific section to some best practices for naming and then quickly finding your blocks. While Google Docs doesn't currently offer a way to create folders within the Docs interface for blocks, a smart naming strategy is key. Firstly, and most importantly, use clear descriptive names. This is my number one tip. When you're creating a block, take an extra 5 seconds to think about what you'll be searching for or what will make sense to future you when you're trying to find it a month later. Instead of a vague name like text snippet or important paragraph, be specific. For example, if you save a block containing the agenda for your weekly team meeting, call it something like Weekly Team Meeting Agenda. If it's the standard closing paragraph for your sales emails, try Email Closing Sales Inquiry. Why is this so important? Because when you use the @ command and start typing, these descriptive names will immediately tell you what's what. You won't have to guess, or worse, insert multiple blocks just to find the right one. And secondly, don't ignore the description field when you create a block. While the name is your primary finding aid, the description can hold extra context. For a block named Product Spec Sheet Model X, the description might be contains technical specifications, dimensions, and warranty info for Model X. This can be invaluable if you have many similar blocks. My third tip is to consider using prefixes for pseudo grouping. Since we don't have traditional folders in the building blocks menu, you can use a consistent prefix at the start of related block names. For instance, if you have many blocks related to client communications, you could start them all with client so that you'd have client onboarding email, client follow-up, and client feedback request. When you use prefixes, not only do the related items group together alphabetically in the main list, but when you type @ and then your prefix, like client, the list immediately filters down to only show you blocks starting with client. This makes it incredibly fast to drill down to the specific block you need. Taking a moment to implement these naming conventions will transform your custom building block list from a random jumble into a well-organized, searchable database of your most used content, which will make you far more efficient. Now, this next point is a subtle but very important one to understand for effectively using custom building blocks, especially if you collaborate with others in Google Docs. And that is knowing where your blocks are stored and how that affects their availability. We've seen that they are essentially individual files in your Google Drive. The key thing is to remember that your custom building blocks are tied to your Google account, not to any specific document that you might be working in at that moment. This is actually fantastic news for your personal productivity. When you create a custom building block, say that company contact block that we made earlier, you can access and use it in any Google Doc that you own or create within that same Google account, because it's pulling from that central library in your Google Drive. So I could create a block while working on Report A today, and then tomorrow when I'm starting a brand new Proposal B from scratch, that same block will be available for me to insert. It's a central library that travels with your account. But what happens when you're working with others? Let's say you insert one of your personal custom building blocks into a document, say for instance using your standard project update block to add your section to a team report. Then you share that document with your colleagues. Your colleagues will be able to see the content, the text, table, whatever it was that you inserted from your block. That content becomes part of the shared document, just like any other text that you might type. However, and this is the crucial distinction, your colleagues will not get that standard project update block added to their personal library of building blocks. It's not in their personal collection of blocks in their drive. So, custom building blocks are, by design, a personal productivity feature first and foremost. They enhance your efficiency across your documents. If a colleague sees a great block that you've used and wants to use it themselves regularly, they would need to select the content that you inserted and then save it as a custom building block within their own Google account. It would then become a new file in their Google Drive. Finally, it's worth a brief mention that the general availability of custom building blocks is, at the time of making this video, only available to Google Workspace or school accounts. Hopefully, it rolls out to consumer accounts in the very near future. But if you are in a workspace or school and you don't see this feature enabled, please be sure to reach out to your admin for more details. So there you have it. By using custom building blocks, you can save a significant amount of time, ensure consistency across all your important documents, and generally boost your productivity in Google Docs. No more endless retyping or hunting for that perfect piece of boilerplate. Think about the repetitive content that you work with and turn it into a handy block. Play around with it. You'll be surprised how quickly it becomes an indispensable part of your workflow. I hope this saves you plenty of time in the future, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel. And if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.